God, since the beginning of this year, God has been speaking to me in the term of culture. And it was around March, the month of March, my wife and I were in St. Vincent and Grenadines. So as Bishop Hans, that Bishop Gibbs introduced me to, came to pick us from the hotel to go to the church. We went to the church and people were so welcoming. After the church, they gave me even the opportunity to speak afternoon. And then as the bishop came to pick us in the afternoon going to the church, the Holy Spirit whispered in my ears, saying, why do you think these people are welcoming toward you? Do you think because you have the same color of the skin? No, it is because you belong to the same kingdom.
Amen.
Because you are citizen of the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Lord, I will say the kingdom of heaven is a reality.
Yeah.
It's not for tomorrow, it's for today. Amen. The kingdom of heaven, beloved, is not different from any other kingdom that we know.
Amen.
The kingdom of heaven has its culture, it has its social institutions, it has its language, it has its political system, it has even a defense system.
Yes.
Angels are soldiers that are keeping safe the children or the citizens of the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven, beloved, as I just said, exists. It exists how? Because since the returning of the Holy Spirit on this planet, the kingdom of heaven started. Because the force or the strength or the identity of the children of God is through the Holy Spirit. And that is why Jesus said, I will not let you alone. I will send the counselor who will be with you and will teach you everything that I've shown you. So the kingdom of heaven, he is here, beloved, by the power of the Holy Spirit. And the kingdom of heaven, as I said, beloved, is not different from any other kingdom. By its culture, that's the way the kingdom of heaven is reflecting itself in this world.
Yes.
Culture is the most important thing. And by the way, that's the topic I want to speak about today. The culture that unites.
Yeah.
The culture that unites.
Yeah.
So the culture of heaven, beloved, exists. Because the kingdom of heaven, as I have said, it's reflected by its culture. Just take the example of British, the Kingdom of Britain. Although today it's a constitutional monarchy, but you will know that this person is a British man when he's open his mouth.
Mm-hmm.
His accent,
yeah.
His English, is the same as the French. There are elements of French culture that testify that this person is a Frenchman. Or the Belgian. The Belgian drink too much beer, they eat French fry with mayonnaise. So if you see someone doing that, you know that this person has to be a Belgian.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Without a delay, I would like us to read the three scriptures. I need the two volunteers can help me. I will read the first one, which is coming from Genesis chapter 11, from verse 1 to 9. And the second scripture will be John chapter 17, verse 20 to 25. And the third one is Acts 2, 1 to 13. I will read the first one, and I would like two people to help me to read the two remaining. Now, the whole world had one language and a common speech. As man moved eastward, they found a plain in Shinar and settled there. They said to each other, come, let me make bricks and bake them dourly. They used brick instead of stone. I will repeat this. They used brick instead of stone and the tar for mortar. Then they said, come, let us build ourselves a city with a tower that reaches to the heavens, so that we may make a name for ourselves and not be scattered all over the face of the world, of the whole earth. But the Lord came down and see the city and the tower that the men were building. The Lord said, if as one people speaking the same language, they have begun to do this, then nothing can stop them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language, so they will not understand each other. So the Lord scattered them from all over the earth, and they stopped building the city. That is why it was called Babel, because the Lord confused the language of the whole world. From there, the Lord scattered them over the face of the world. Eight. Second reading, volunteer.
John 17, verse
20-25.
And the glory which thou hast given me, I have given unto them, that they may be one, even as we are one. I in them, and thou in me, that they may be perfected into one, that the world may know that thou didst send me, and lovest them, even as thou lovest me. Father, I desire that they also whom thou hast given me be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundations of the world.
Amen. The third one, anybody? Okay, if nobody wants to read, I will read it. Acts chapter 2, verse 1 to 13. Amen.
Amen.
As I said today, I wanted us to reflect on the topic, the culture that unites. Maybe you are asking yourself, what is culture then? I'm glad that you ask yourself that question. Culture is defined by the dictionary as a set of characteristics that define a group of people in terms of belief, philosophy, art, cuisine, customs. In one word, culture is the identity of a people. You know, Alexander the Great, for us who know the history, the Greek king or emperor, believed that the world will be united by the Greek culture, So Alexander the Great believed that all the world that the Greek conquered can be one only if all of them become under one culture, which is the culture of Greece. I said, in certain extent, he was right, because a people is defined as a people not for what they look outwardly, but for what they are inside, culture. The culture Culture, beloved, is, in other words, the glory of a kingdom, the glory of a people. Like I will say that God, when he created Adam, God didn't create Adam with a religion. God created Adam with a kingdom. Because what was God's instruction to Adam? Fill the earth, subdue the earth. In other words, fill the earth and dominate, rule over the earth. So God gave a portion of his power to Adam. And that's what Adam lost. Adam didn't lose a religion, but he lost the kingdom. And Jesus coming into the world didn't come to restore a religion that he called Christianity. Jesus came to restore the kingdom of heaven that Adam lost. So God, by telling Adam that rule over the earth, fill the earth, God was telling Adam, take a portion of my culture, the portion of the kingdom, and fill it all over the earth for my glory. Because God's intention was the earth to please be the extension of the kingdom of heaven, where everything is influenced by him for his glory. But the sin, we know as it came, and it altered God's plan. But as the Bible says that God never repented from his calling, from his plan, God came up with another way to come and redeem the world, to bring back the world under his influence. We have to note one thing. There is a big difference between the world and the earth. There is no problem with the earth. The earth as it is what it is. But the world is where the problem is. Because the world was the governing system that was supposed to govern the earth. And Adam lost it to the benefit of the one that we call evil or devil. He's the one that is leading the world as it is today. He's leading the world according to his will. While for God, the world was supposed to be the reflection of his glory. The word in Hebrew, glory, means kabod, or in Greek, doxa. There are two words, in other words, are the same words used for culture. So God, by giving Adam his glory to reflect on the earth, God was giving Adam his culture to expand it all over the world, for the world to be for the glory of God. In other words, God was giving Adam the instruction to expand the culture of the kingdom of heaven on earth. So, if we can talk about the culture that unites, it means there is a culture that divides.
Yes.
So, what is that culture that divides? I will say without delay that the culture of this world divides. Because the world sees division in diversity, but God sees unity in diversity. So, if you are following the news, I was speaking on my own shame. You know what is happening in South Africa? People killing people. People destroying people. It means black people killing black people. Why? We are supposed to be one people, isn't it? Because we have the same color of the skin. If you see a South African and me, what's the difference?
Yeah.
But because of cultural context, South African claiming that the land that they call South Africa belongs to them. Therefore, if you are not from that culture, a divisive culture, the culture of the world, you don't belong to South Africa, therefore get out. But a people is a people, not because they look like outside. A people is a people because they have the same culture. So, when God created a human person, God created just one person, that Adam. From Adam, he brought out Eve. From Eve, then all of us came. So, in other words, God created just one race, which is a human race. God didn't create the race as we define them today. We are defining this, what we call a race, because of the fallen nature that took place and is leading this world. I will say too that God, by creating the earth, he created one nation. created one nation to be governed by the world. In other words, God didn't create all the borders that we have today. Whatever we have today as borders are the result of what happened in Genesis chapter 11, when God scattered them all over the world. By that confusion, they lost even the trace of where they came, and they started creating what we call today nations. And that is what we say that South Africa can claim that South Africa belongs to them. And even here, we hear the speech, people want to invade our countries because we are defining borders based on what we see. But before God, there is just one world. Before God, there is just one people, the human race. So, beloved, I have just said, God created one nation. And what happened? In Genesis chapter 11, we are in the beginning. Because this is Genesis, it means the beginning. So it was after the fall of Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. So humankind were already under the influence of enemy. Satan was already influencing the world. And then Satan came and put in devil in their mind an ambitious ambition, an ambition that was against the will of God. The ambition that don't go all over the world, just stay in one place. Be one place and don't scatter over the world. They worked against the will of God. Because the will of God was what to Adam? Multiply, fill the earth. But Satan telling them, stay in one place, don't go all over the world. And what is very interesting is that he said, build a name for yourself. While God created the world to be not for anyone else's glory, for his own glory. Amen. What was supposed to be on earth was supposed to be only for the glory of God.
Yes, amen.
So, God created human person to administer his kingdom all over the earth. But these people wanted to stay one place. You know, the difference between a kingdom and a republic is what? In a kingdom, when the king says, whatever the king says something, that thing becomes law. Yes. You don't have to debate what the king says. But in a republic, we can debate because we have a democratic culture. And God never said that he was a president. If you read the Bible, there is no place the Bible says that God is the president. God is the king.
Yeah.
And if God says something, you don't have to debate it. You accept it.
Amen.
But in the democratic system, as I've just said, we can debate things because sometimes it don't make sense to us. We want it to make sense so that we can accept or reject it. So in other words, I would say these people, they had already a democratic culture of debating what God said. The word of God was multiplied, filled the earth, scattered all over the earth. They said, no, let's stay in place, one place, and make a name for ourselves. And we know God had to come down to scatter them. Those people, our ancestors, so whatever is going to this world is coming from them.
Yeah.
They are our ancestors.
Yes.
We cannot escape what they did. So we are just bearing the consequences of their rebellion. So, as these people had a democratic culture, I have said, they debated what God said. And today, even in the church, with this sign, we are bringing the democratic culture to debate what God said. We debate if the majority votes for it, even if it is against what God said, we adopt it. God told Israel, you don't have to eat a young goat while it's still in the milk. But today we are eating goats that is still in the milk because we have a democratic We have to debate. Why not to eat a gluten that is in milk? Maybe you are wondering what gluten milk means. Today, we are allowing pedophilia. We are allowing children pornography. Even in the church, those things are happening. And we are defending it because it's a democracy. We are even changing marriage, the way God defined marriage, in terms of democracy. We need to accommodate everyone. No, beloved, in the kingdom, the word of the king is law. You do not debate it. In the kingdom, you accept. If you don't want to accept, get out. That is because the king remains the king.
Yeah.
So the culture of this world, beloved, divide because, first of all, the world is divided. In the world, we have the north and the south. We have the have and the have not. We have the strong and the weak. We have the young and the big. We have women and men. We have black and white. We have all kinds of divisions that are dividing this world. How can a world like that be united?
Yes, Jesus.
Never. But God wanted the world to be one.
Yeah.
God wanted human race to be one for the sake of the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
And I will say, whatever we are calling immigration today, we have people migrating all over back here and there. I say to a certain extent it's the will of God. Because that's what was supposed to be in place in the first place anyway.
Yes.
People were supposed to move all over the earth to fill it for the sake of the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
And I will say, if you are against immigration, it means you are in the culture of disruption in Genesis chapter 11. Your ancestors' spirit is leading you to be against what God intended for this world. And I was thinking about even when meditating on this passage, I said, I don't support slavery, I don't support colonialism, but I understand maybe God allowed it so that people can move all over the world. God allowed it so that he can move people from Africa to the Caribbean to the Europe, European to the Africa, so that that's what is planned anyway from the beginning.
Yeah.
Because we see different color, but God sees one people.
Yeah.
He sees one person,
Amen.
Human race.
Amen.
So the builder of this tower, beloved, as the Bible says, were already out of God's will. They wanted to build a tower, to build a name for themselves in expense of God's glory. Remain one place. Let us be one place so that we cannot scatter all over the world. And to scatter them, God confused the language. You know, language is the most important component of any culture. You cannot communicate if you don't speak the same language. You are the same people when you understand each other from the language. I could not be speaking to you now if I didn't know English.
Amen.
I could not tell my wife that I love her when I met her the first time if I didn't know English.
Amen.
So I could have the love I had for her, but there could not be a way to express it because language barrier. And language is defined as the expression of thought. Whatever you think, you translate it through language, then that a person can understand.
Yeah.
So God put a barrier, confused them, so that they cannot understand each other. So by then, the culture of the world divide.
Mm-hmm.
So the question now you ask yourself, what is that culture that unites? The culture of God unites you.
Yes.
Jesus Christ unites humankind for the glory of God.
Yeah.
Remember, the devil told Jesus in the Garden of Eden that if you just bow before me, I will give you all this glory. You see all this earth? It was given to me. Just bow down before me and I give it to you. But Jesus told him, away from me, Satan. You will worship just God and God alone. In other words, Jesus told the devil, I don't need the glory, I have to obey the one who sent me.
Amen.
If you did it with Adam, the Garden of Eden, with me, I have defeated you because I have to remain in the will of the one who sent me.
Yes.
I came in this world not to get the glory for myself. I came into this world to rebuild the glory of the one who created the heavens and earth. And that's why Jesus was able to unite humankind. Jesus united human beings for the sake not to make a name for himself, but to make the name of God be known. The kingdom, every king, person beloved demonstrates his, who he is through his actions. And remember, the culture is the reflection of the people. So, if we say that we belong to God, the reflection or whatever we are reflecting have to show that we are of God's culture. We belong to the culture of God. For the world to unite, as I've said, Jesus had to unite humankind. If, as long as human beings are not united, there is no a united world. And that is why, in South Africa, they can claim that South Africa belongs to them. Mm-hmm. And here, with the Trump administration, we said America belongs to us. But if we are united, we will be able to understand that the world belongs to God, and we belong to God, and therefore we live for the glory of God.
Yeah.
So the culture, a culture unites people. That is why Alexander the Great said, it will be good for all the world to have the Greek culture so they can be united.
Yes.
And I think the Greek culture, in a certain extent, will continue to colonize this world. Through the thoughts, democracy came from the Greeks. Because the Greek thought, although they didn't apply, but the Roman came and they took it and applied. That is why we have the world. You go from, if you go to Washington DC, you see all the official buildings are built according to the Greek architecture. So in certain extent, Alexander the Great was great. He was right that the world can be united through culture. And yes, I said Jesus, only the culture of God can unite people. The culture of the world can never unite because the world is a divided place anyway. Just look at United Nations. I don't have anything against the United Nations. It's a good idea. It was a great idea. After the Second World War, we said, oh, because many people have died, let us now create a framework where that we can be united. If we have a problem, we can sit down and have dialogue and resolve our problems. Do you think that the war doesn't exist anymore in the world? We see how the United Nations is unable to make the world a better, to make the world a better place. Because first of all, it's facing many cultures. It's facing many ways of doing things, many ways of thinking. Therefore, the United Nations cannot unite. And of course, it's even dividing. We in Africa, we said, let us build an African Union. Let us come together, build African Union. But what is happening in South Africa? Really, is there unity? No. The culture of the world can never unite, beloved. Only the culture of God will unite.
Amen.
Unity is very important for God.
Yes.
As I said in the beginning, God sees unity in diversity. Amen. But in the world, we see division in diversity.
Yeah.
So that is why Jesus, when he said, if you want to pray, pray like this. He said, our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come.
Yes.
Because only the kingdom of God can unite the people in the world.
Amen.
Jesus, in other words, said, ask God to send back his culture. When you have the culture of God, then you will be one people. And it is a prayer, as Mrs. Gibbs read it in John chapter 17, Jesus said what? I have given you the glory that you gave me. Glorify your name. I'm not praying for all, only for these here, but I'm praying even for those who will accept or will agree with the message, so that they may be one as you and me are one.
Yeah.
Unity is very important for God because unity, God is unity that works in diversity. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. But he's one.
Mm-hmm.
So God unites us through his culture. So, in other words, I wanted to say that the culture is, unity is the culture of heaven. So if you don't unite, it means you are working against God.
My God.
If you don't bring together, it means you are scattering, you are a rebel as your ancestors in Genesis chapter 11. You want to make a name for yourself.
My God.
So Jesus Christ belonged, as I said, that the language is the most important component of the culture.
Yeah.
Restore the language of humankind so that human can understand each other in the day of Pentecost. When the Holy Spirit came back, finally, he inaugurated the understanding of language. Today we can understand each other in biblical language because the Holy Spirit has made us able to be the citizen of the kingdom of heaven. And therefore we have the culture of God. That is why we can be one in unity.
Yeah.
As I said, the kingdom of heaven exists. It's not for tomorrow. Those who are led by the Holy Spirit, they are the ones who are citizens of the kingdom of God. Those who are inhabited by the Holy Spirit, they are the ones who are working in unity, not for their namesake, but for the sake of the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
You know, the blood of Jesus that was shed on the cross of Calvary purified the human body so that it can be again a residence for the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, there is no kingdom of heaven on earth. The kingdom of heaven on earth is only present by the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, amen.
During the time, Jesus was the only person who had the culture of God.
Yes.
Because that is why he didn't call his disciples brothers until after he went on the cross, died, resurrected, then he called them my brother. Because he knew that now I have given them the opportunity, I have given them the power and the right to become citizens of the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Beloved, we are those, we are the product of what Jesus accomplished on the cross. Therefore, we are citizens of the kingdom of heaven. The culture that we have is not the culture of this world. Of course, I'm Congolese. When you see me with this food, you said, oh, he's African. But in reality, in me, I have the culture of God. That is why I can call Bishop Gibbs my brother.
Yeah.
I can call you brothers.
Amen.
The culture of heaven unites.
Yes.
Unity is only possible by the culture of God.
Yes.
You will never find unity with the world. You know, we Congolese, in Congo alone, we have 745 tribes,
my God,
which in the past were kingdoms before the European came. So in a context like that, how can people be united with all different languages? You know, that part of Congo, when I speak, they cannot understand me. And if they speak, I cannot understand them. But yet we said we are united under one flag. That's a resemblance, but it's not a reality.
Come on
now. In reality, we are divided people.
Yeah. That's right.
The true country is this one here.
Yeah.
Although we have many flags,
Yes.
But we are one people, nation under God, not the United States, but the nation that Jesus Christ inaugurated on the cross of Calvary, the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Beloved, you know, I'm almost at the end. The fall of human being and the rebellion that they laid on the Babel Tower and God scattered them, it created even a deeper emptiness in humankind. The absence of God's culture in human beings created an emptiness.
Yeah.
And to fill that emptiness, human being created all kind of theory, just like the one they had at the beginning, let us build a tower for ourselves. And human came with a theory like humanism. Humanism, that concept that humankind is in the center of his existence. He's the only one to decide what he wants. There is no super being above him. And humanism led to what we call secularism. To Caesar what belongs to Caesar, to God what belongs to God. But who is the creator of this world? God is the creator of this world.
Yes.
And only God can take all the glory.
Amen.
Because he's the author, he's the architecture,
yes,
and he's the builder,
yeah,
of what we call creation.
Yeah.
And especially you and me. You know, there is no other creature that God created in his image.
God
didn't tell the angel that you are created in my image.
Uh-uh.
No. God didn't tell the lion, even though they call the lion the king of the jungle,
come on
now, in his image. God created us,
yes,
in his image.
Amen.
It means God gave us his glory,
yes,
to shine it,
yes,
on the earth,
yes,
to reveal it to,
yes,
the whole creation. God, in other words, gave us his culture, as I said at the beginning, to expand it, dominate the earth for his glory.
Yes.
We lost it, but Jesus Christ came to restore it. And that is why,
yeah,
if you claim that you are a child of God, your behavior,
yes,
your attitude,
yes,
your way of doing things,
yes,
have to show to the world clearly,
yes,
that you are a child of God.
Amen.
That you are a citizen of the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
Because that is what your culture is.
Yes.
Right.
Your culture is not what we call nation, our nationalities.
Mm-mm.
Our culture is the culture of heaven.
Yes.
The culture that Jesus Christ came to inaugurate,
yes,
on the cross.
Yes.
You know, the concept of tower, the tower symbolizes, I can say three things. When you see like Eiffel Tower in France, it symbolizes power,
yes,
it symbolizes unity and communication. You see, for our cell phone to be able to receive signals, we have to raise towers.
Yeah.
So the Holy Spirit is the symbol of the three components I've just said. The Holy Spirit is the symbol of power. The Holy Spirit is the symbol of communication between the kingdom, the citizen of the kingdom of heaven, and the Holy Spirit is a unity for the children of God.
Amen.
The Lord, today is International Day.
Mm-hmm.
When God is looking down, he's seeing one person, one race.
Yes.
He's seeing one nation.
Yes.
The kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Therefore, you understand why Jesus said, if you hate your neighbors, you hate yourself.
Come on now.
Because you have to love your neighbor as you love yourself.
My God.
Because before God, we are one person.
Yes.
Only the culture of God can unite. May God bless us.
Hallelujah.